We do everything from restoration projects to schools to churches to high-end residential work. We're all interested and dedicated to Birmingham. So a lot of our work is focused in that region. But specifically tonight, I want to focus on our work in rehabilitation and restoration. This is the 16th Street Baptist Church, and this is a real restoration project. The history of the church, which I always found interesting, is to get into all of this, but the architect who designed it was Wallace Rayfield. He was only the second trained African-American architect in the country, trained at Tuskegee University. This building was built in 1910 and was a prominent black church in Birmingham. So just the fact that they could build something like this in that time period with a African-American architect is hugely significant. You can kind of notice some things as you look at these old pictures. The steps were limestone. These little doors that went down to this lower level, kind of a fellowship hall. It's kind of an open area. Of course, differences in the streetscape and the trees around there and the neighborhood around there. Today, this church is basically by itself, and the Civil Rights Institute is directly across the street from it, but there's not a residential neighborhood around it anymore, so it's different today. So the history, as we all know, was very serious on September 15, 1963, with the bombing of this church. The girls were in the basement restroom off of the fellowship hall when the bomb went off, and it was right here. The four girls were killed, and we just celebrated kind of the anniversary of that in our city this past September. So it's something that is part of all of us. It's part of our story in Birmingham, and you know, we're trying to bring that back together, but it is serious and chilling to think that this could have happened in our country. But as we think about what this was, the good things that have come out of it are numerous. The church was a hub for the civil rights movement in the 60s, so that meant everybody starting these marches was here. I mean, all that history happened right here. This shows the restored project on the exterior. It was a massive masonry repointing job. It was re-roofing of portions of the roof. There is a very shallow pitch flat roof beyond here, and that dome is kind of in the middle of it. Steps were fully rebuilt, and a major perimeter waterproofing exercise was done around the perimeter. And you'll see, like, the differences here. We have those little enclosed spaces that were enclosed in the 60s. We see a sign here that was hung up on this church during the 60s. So this was a church that was restored to the period of significance, which was 1963. It wasn't restored to 1910 when it was built. It was restored to a period of significance in our history. So that's one of the significant differences about this case study, is that all the research went to defining what were those things in the 60s that made this building what it was. You know, when we put the sign back up, I think some people were excited, but some people didn't understand. You know, why would you put that back up on that building? But it truly was part of the setting for that period. So here we get into a little bit of before shots. You can see that the steps before restoration were covered in kind of a ceramic tile, where they had tried to cover up problems with the limestone that's underneath there. And then what happened was water was getting under that tile and causing that to pop up. So that was becoming a major hazard. They had painted the stonework here to try to look like the steps. We had a number of joints. It's hard to see in this photo, but the stone base had a number of mortar joints that were just missing. And some of that was due to, on the east side, the bombing obviously created some major cracks. But this church also sits in a geological area of the city that has something that we call expansive clay soil. And so the ground shrinks and swells with the seasons and causes buildings that are masonry in particular to crack under those pressures. This is the effort of stopping what was going on with the soil around the perimeter of the building. This is a really a trench that was created around the entire structure where we went back in, cleaned the wall, repointed the wall, put waterproofing on the wall, and then created, in this case, a separate wall and filled all this with gravel to prevent the basement from leaking. The basement, they would have an event, they would have dignitaries visiting this building, it would be flooding. So we've been able to control that with this, but it was a massive, massive undertaking. The other thing that we did was we unfortunately had to cut down all the street trees because the roots of those trees were creating additional cracks in the masonry of the building. So we had to get those out and then create concrete planters so that trees could be planted and their root structure wouldn't try to interfere with the foundation of the building. So here's a view of the restored east elevation. The bombing went off here, and they've now erected a plaque here to remember the four girls.